5 investigates getting some answers after a young man overdosed and later died while admitted to the state's top mental health recovery center and hospital.
His mother told the heartbreaking story to our Kathy Curran. Take a look.
When the lights go off at night and people are asleep, I cry all night long until the sun rises. And I miss him so, so much.
A mother heartbroken.
Is he breathing?
Do you put your trust in the Worcester Recovery Center and the Department of Mental Health to get him the help that he needed?
I gave you my son out of trust. You gave him back to me dead.
Cheryl Labonte hoped this time her son David, who struggled with mental illness, would get the help he so desperately needed. But after a few months at the Worcester Recovery Center and hospital, he was found unresponsive in his room and died a few days later. According to the medical examiner, David overdosed on cocaine laced with fentanyl, the drugs making their way inside the state's premier $302 million mental health facility.
Where did he get it?
His mother says in the months before he died, David told her illegal drugs were seeping into the hospital and he was worried.
When I called the nursing staff and I told them what was happening.
What did they say?
We'll deal with it.
Do you think they ever dealt with it properly?
No, my son's dead. So I don't think so.
According to records obtained by 5 investigates, the state has investigated at least 6 overdoses within the facility since 2016. In one case, a patient OD'd on a white powdery substance, another on what was believed to be heroin laced with fentanyl brought in by a staff member. The Worcester County District Attorney and the Department of Mental Health have launched investigations into David's case.
My heart goes out to the family.
Joan McCula oversees the Department of Mental Health.
When you see how drugs come into places, they come in ways that we would never think. So we can do a better mainstream job, and we're trying to do that.
To be able to get drugs like that in, it's appalling to me.
What's also appalling to this grieving mother is what she was told when she reached out to officials at the Worcester Recovery Center and Hospital, asking for help with funeral expenses or counseling for her family. She says a top administrator told her to start a GoFundMe page.
To get help for my family to recover from this horrific thing that happened, I'm totally offended.
They were told to start a GoFundMe page.
Well, I'm sorry that that was the message they got. I would encourage the family. We will actually reach out to them and see if there are ways that we can redirect and be helpful.
There's a hole in my heart in the shape of Dave, and I don't think I can ever fill it.
And after we spoke with the commissioner, the department did reach out to the Labonte family to help with counseling. As for the drug problem, the facility was put on lockdown and searched after David's overdose. The state is working on improving security. Kathy Curran, 5 investigates.